Premature babies or very small birth weight babies, they have very thin skin and they don't have the ability to insulate themselves. Temperature is one of our first signs of either something going wrong or everything's going right. We're looking for quality care here, so that means consistency. So something we do is we monitor the temperature every hour on these babies.
Temperature monitoring has not advanced technologically since the 1990s. The electronic probe is rigid and is stressful for the baby. And then it also takes a lot of work from nurses to monitor frequently and then recording them.
One of our main focuses in our hospital right now is initiating kangaroo care immediately. So what that means is we want the mom to actually be able to hold the baby on her skin, bare chest, with just a blanket covering them. And what that does is it promotes bonding for the baby and the mother. It also helps the baby stay warm, and it helps actually maintain their vital signs better. So it's very disruptive to have to come in and manually take their temperature during that experience.
We would like to be able to have a wireless solution where the baby could be monitored remotely without having to constantly disrupt them, but have it be accurate enough so that we have a good idea of what's going on with their temperature.
If we had a wireless temperature probe, that would be a stress that parents here wouldn't even have to ever experience.
I learned about inside of the intensive care unit and monitoring newborn babies. I saw that perhaps there was an opportunity for us engineers to work with clinicians to try to automate that process using a very simple wireless and unobtrusive technology.
TI has been working on temperature sensor technology for almost 50 years, and we've taken that expertise and really applied it to create a high accuracy, highly integrated, low power solution.
So the full system has to be very small. Ideally, you want to place it somewhere on the baby that gives an accurate reading of temperature. This needs to be ideally embedded in some type of material that's routinely used in the hospital that's FDA approved. Fortunately, our research group had been working in areas that addressed many of those challenges, but we still had to connect the dots. Our intention was for this technology to be inside of an ICU. Therefore, you cannot sacrifice the accuracy of the system. So in that regard, we began to look around at what companies have very small, thin chips that nonetheless have quite a bit of accuracy, and we learned about this suite of chips that Texas Instruments was beginning to introduce, and step by step, the accuracy was approaching clinical grade accuracy, and indeed, the most recent chip that is newly announced meets that constraint.
The TMP117 is our first product that's able to hit 0.1 degree accuracy across a range of 30 to 45 degrees. We bring in the temperature sensor, the signal conditioning, and data acquisition all into a single chip. And this is really hitting that sweet spot of body temperature measurement and meets the needs of the American and European standards for patient monitoring.
So we've done testing on human subjects, and we're now in the process of deploying these here at UC San Francisco with our clinical collaborators in newborns. So we will be continuing the adult testing, ironing out the kinks, and beginning the process to do this in newborns. Having an opportunity to, you know, develop this level of innovation for arguably our most vulnerable patient population, newborns. They can't speak, they can't defend for themselves, they have their whole life ahead of them. It's a very exciting opportunity.
My hope for the future is that we will have all wireless vital signs. I think the families would have a better experience, I think the babies would have a better experience, and I think we would have more reliable data. I kind of said it before, I believe that quality care is consistent care, and I think that if we had a device that would be able to deliver a more consistent temperature reading, that we would be able to have better outcomes for our babies.